Good morning. So my name is Maggie Diamond, as Anne introduced me. So for the past couple months, Anne and I have been working together to take a deeper look at patent litigation trends, including trends in patent jury trials. We looked at the top districts hearing these disputes. We looked at how likely a dispute was to make it to trial in these districts. And we looked at the time it took for each of these disputes to reach trial across these districts. To do this, we used the online database Lex Machina. All information that's in this presentation and the handout in front of you is from this database. The handout also has more information in it than what you'll see up here today. And for people who are interested, the charts in there are actually my favorite thing that we worked on, but it's kind of complicated and would take too much time to talk about today. So one of the first questions we asked was, what does the patent litigation field look like broadly in terms of patent filings per year, number of patent trials a year, number of patent jury trials a year? The axis on the left hand is in the thousands, and it corresponds to the number of patent filings in each year. And as you can see, the number of patent filings has increased over the years with the lead up to the 2011 implementation of the America Invents Act, Section 299, you see the big uptick. The other thing I wanted to point out on this trend is the 2013 to 2015. You see the peak in the number of patent filings in 2013, followed by a dip in 2014 and a pick back up again in 2015. On the right-hand side, you have an axis that's measured in the tens, and that corresponds to the number of patent trials and patent jury trials each year. And what you see, a number of patent trials, is from 2013 to 2015, you have that same sort of trend where it peaks in 2013 with 126 trials, drops in 2014 to 111, and then increases again in 2014. Interestingly, this trend is not mimicked in the patent jury trials. From 2013 to 2015, it maintains some relatively steady, ranging from 71 to 73 patent jury trials in those years. So naturally, now knowing the number of patent trials and the number of patent jury trials in each year, we sought to examine, of all of the patent trials going on, what percentage of those are tried by juries. What we found was that the clear majority of patent trials are tried by jury trials in every year since 2009. 2012 saw the largest percentage of patent jury trials, with 66% of all patent trials tried by jury. Over the years, this has been relatively steady. For context, in 2015, 59% of patent trials were tried by jury. One thing I wanted to point out on this slide, and it applies to all times, both in the presentation and the handout, that we talk about jury trials and bench trials. Lex Machina has three categorizations for patent trials: trial, bench trial, jury trial. Some cases can be double tagged as patent trial or jury trial. That's if the case had both a component of a bench trial and a jury trial. Some cases are only tagged as trial, and this is if the docket indicates that there was a trial, but not what sort of trial. However, even the number of cases that were marked just as trial was relatively low. So low that even if you assume that all of those trials were bench trials, patent jury trials still took the majority in every single year since 2009. So, knowing that patent jury trials comprise the majority of patent trials, we asked, where are these trials occurring? Cumulatively, from 2009 to 2015, the top five districts comprised 52% of all patent jury trials. It's no surprise to anyone that the Eastern District of Texas was the number one placeholder with 120 trials during this period, or 23% of all patent jury trials. That was followed by the District of Delaware with 62 trials during this period, the Northern District and the Central District of California with 39 and 25 trials each year, and the number five placeholder was the District of Massachusetts with 21 patent jury trials from 2009 to 2015. So when we went to look at each district's share of patent jury trials, what we found was that the share of each district was not static across or within each of those years. So the graph you see here looks at the top five districts by patent of by number of patent jury trials and other districts. The orange box on the bottom represents all other districts. The red box is the Eastern District of Texas. The blue box is the District of Delaware. The Northern District of California is in purple. The Central District is in green and maroon for the District of Massachusetts. The Eastern District, what I'd like to point out here is that the Eastern District of Texas was the number one placeholder for every year besides 2014, where the District of Delaware beat it with its 13 patent jury trials to the Eastern District's 11. The other thing I'd like to point out here is that in 2012, you saw the greatest number of patent jury trials, the greatest percent of patent jury trials were tried outside the top five districts. As I mentioned earlier, 2012 was also the year that saw the greatest percentage of all patent trials tried by jury, suggesting that in this year, that was in part attributed to patent jury trials outside of the top five districts. So next, thinking back to the first slide, you remember that the number of patent filings was this massive number in the thousands, and the number of patent trials was a much smaller number. So we asked, how likely is a dispute filed in any one of these districts to make it, how likely is it to make it to trial? For this, we switched from the top five districts by number of patent jury trial, and we looked at the top five districts by number of patent filings. This had a limited effect. It only replaced the District of New Jersey as the number five spot holder and bumped out the District of Massachusetts. What we noticed was at a national level, if you look at the trial section, 1.8% of all patent disputes resulted in a trial resolution. The vast majority of patent disputes are resolved through settlement, 76% on the national level. The Eastern District of Texas exceeded this in the settlement rate of 85% of all patent disputes resolved by settlement, and only 1% of disputes were resolved by trial. Overall, there was only three districts in the top five districts by patent filing that met or exceeded the national rate of trial resolutions. Those were, if you focus on the trial resolution section right now, those were the District of Delaware in red, the Northern District of California, and the District of New Jersey. The District of Delaware had 1.9%. The Central District of California had 2.3%, and the District of New Jersey had 4.1% of disputes resolved by trial. In the handout in front of you, there's additional information on timing that both looks at the districts and cross-compares bench trials to jury trials, as well as how patents are the grounds on which patents are resolved, and the invalidity finding grounds.